Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
What is Shastra Shraddha? What is Lukika Shraddha? Let me explain. So, Shastra Shraddha means what Shastra Siddhantas are there. Especially, the Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence of all Vedas, all Upanishadas. Sarva Vedanta Saram is Srimad Bhagavatam Ishyate. Rasamurta Tuttasya Nanyatra Siddhrati Kuchit. This is the essence of all Veda Vedanta Upanishadas, is Srimad Bhagavatam. So one has unflinching faith. In Srimad Bhagavatam, what are said in Srimad Bhagavatam, teachings are given, was unflinching faith. With Srimad Bhagavatam, the essence of all Vedas, all Upanishadas, all Vedic literatures, Shraddha, Shastriya Shraddha, and Srila Jiva Goswami has put emphasis on Shastriya Shraddha. One should develop Shastriya Shraddha, not Lukika Shraddha. One is neophyte devotee, Kanishtha Adhikari, he has only Lukika Shraddha, not Shastriya Shraddha. Therefore, we are citing that, who is Kanishtha. Lukika Shraddha means only he believes or puts faith in the words of those materialistic person, materialistic scientist, philosophers, all these things. He has not developed faith in the words of sadhus, vaishnavas, mahajanas, those who are acharyas, have not developed faith in that. That is Lukika Shraddha. As for example, people here in this locality say, oh, there is a ghost. There is a ghost in that tree. People of this locality say, one comes here, he hears from them, people say there is a ghost. This is Lukika Shraddha. So when we may be coming by this side and the electricity is off, the dense darkness, so he sees something, somebody standing there, putting on white cloth, ghost is there, because he has heard it, from this people of this is Lukika Shraddha. But when electricity comes, he says, what is this? Oh, it's a dead tree. A dead tree. It looks white. But he says, it's a ghost. This is Lukika Shraddha. But we should not develop Lukika Shraddha. We have to hear. We should develop Shastra Shraddha. Unless you develop Shastra Shraddha, unless you deal like this, what Narada Muni has instructed here, then what happens? You'll be affected by the threefold miseries. This material world will never be happy at all. So those are offenders. Skanda Purana says, who are offenders? There are six types of offenders, Skanda Purana says, and they all fall down and go to Rourava Narka. Nindam kurvanti je mudha vaishnavanam mahatmanam padanti pitruvisardham maharourava sangeete hanti nindanti vaidvesti vaishnavanabhinandati krudhyate jati noharsam darsane patanani sat. Skanda Purana says, nindam kurvanti je mudha vaishnavanam mahatmanam. Those who blasphemy Mahatma Vaishnavas. They are great offenders. Patanti Pitru Visardam Maharoro Sangike. They will definitely go to Maharoro Vanarkar. Not only they, Pitru Visardam. All his ancestors also. Pitru Purushpur, fathers also. That is what it says. Six types of offenders. Number one, those who try to kill a Vaishnava. Number two, those who blaspheme Vaishnava. Number three, sing Vaishnava, one who doesn't pay pranam, obeisances. Number four, one who gets angry with a Vaishnava. Number five, one who develops enmity with a Vaishnava. Number six, sing a Vaishnava, one who doesn't become jolly. Huh? Curse the first one. Offender. Here, Prabhupada says, instead of being envious of a more qualified man, one should be jolly to receive him. Yes. Instead of becoming jolly, he becomes envious. Calls his face. He's offended. Huh? So, these are six types of offenders fall down to Maharaurava Narka. Huh? Maharaurava Narka. Srila Prabhupada formed this society of Krishna consciousness. This is the society of Vaishnavas. Why form this society of Krishna consciousness? Because those who join this society, those who be member of this society, they should develop complete Krishna consciousness. The opportunity is given here. Complete Krishna consciousness. Jomang pasyati sadvatra sarvangcha mai pasyati. Tasyang na panasyami satame na panasyati. This is complete Krishna consciousness. One who sees, Krishna says, one who sees me everywhere, thabar jangama dekhe na dekhe tar murti sarvatra hoi tar ishta deva spurti. He sees moving and unmoving, never sees the outward form, sees ishta, most beloved deity, Krishna everywhere. Sarvatra hoi tar ishta deva spurti. Everywhere. Jahan nitra pade tahan Krishna spure. Jahan nitra pade tahan Krishna spure. Wherever he looks, he sees Krishna. Who is such person? Bhakto ama preme bandhiya chhe hrudayo bhitare bhakto bhakto ama preme bandhiya chhe hrudayo bhitare bhakto that bhakta, that devotee who has bound me up in his heart with the rope of love. Jahan netro pade tahan dekho hi amare. Jahan netro pade tahan dekho hi amare. Saje bhakta. Jahan netra pade tahan dekho hi amare. Wherever he looks, he sees me. He sees me. Saje bhakta, premi bhakta, was bound up Krishna with the rope of love in his heart. He can see Krishna everywhere. He can see Krishna everywhere. Otherwise, nobody can see Krishna everywhere. Krishna said, Nahu prakasa sarvasya yoga maya samabhruta mudhayam nabhijanati. These are the words of Krishna. I never manifest before everybody. I never manifest everywhere. I am covered up with my yogamaya potency. Mudhayam abhijanvane mudha. Krishna says them, they are mudhas. They are rascals. He cannot see me. He cannot understand. Mudhayam abhijanati. In other words, Krishna keeps himself hidden. Huh? If Krishna keeps himself hidden, how can we see him? Huh? How can we see him? Huh? He keeps himself hidden. Who can see him? Huh? That he says. Vakta ama premi mandiha jehude vite dahan nitra pade tahan dekhayavar. Such premi vakta only can see. Was developed Krishna prema, was bound of Krishna in his heart, rope of love. Rope of love. This bondage is very, very strong. Even Almighty Krishna, who is Almighty, he cannot break it. He says, no paroye, no paroye, no paroye. I cannot, I cannot, I cannot. Such bondage is a strong bondage. Even Almighty Krishna cannot break it. So Krishna cannot keep himself hidden before the eyes of such a premi bhakta. His premi bhakta sees him everywhere, though Krishna keeps himself hidden. So this is the society of Krishna consciousness. This is Srila Prabhupada formed this society of Krishna consciousness, because one will come and join, member of this society of Krishna consciousness, this opportunity is given here to develop complete Krishna consciousness. Yes, see Krishna everywhere. Jumam pasyati sarvatra, sarvam samai pasyati, sasyam na pranasyami, sadamai na pranasyati. This is the goal. Prabhupada, these are Prabhupada words. Prabhupada has written in his book, Krishna consciousness movement aims at creating an atmosphere of non-envy. Of course, it is not possible for everyone to become Krishna conscious, but the Krishna consciousness movement can create an exemplary society wherein there is no envy. That is the question of enviousness. Who is envious? He is not a Krishna conscious person. In other words, he is not a Vaishnava at all. There should be no other purpose of Srila Prabhupada forming this society. If this purpose fails, how Srila Prabhupada will be happy?